Hello everybody, Shaman Karmat here. Saturday evening, a new edition of our Steam Blitz chess tournament. Every Saturday evening, 20 GMT time, we make this tournament. At the moment we have 12 players registered. We start in 30 seconds. So let's see that all players are registered. Jose Gonzalez is not registered, so I hope he registers after the game immediately. So, a few seconds to go. It's 5 minutes plus 2 seconds nine, increment per move.
Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero.
So let's go. So I have the black pieces now in this first game against Jose Gonzalez. That's a new player in the tournament. Okay. So his opening choice is somewhat strange. So we have a completely unusual opening. Now this pawn here is hanging. It's not protected. Now it's protected. Now the rook is attacked. This pawn is protected by the knight. Okay, this bishop I take. And let's ask the knight what it's about to do. And then just pawn storm my pawns into the opponent's camp. And now the rook is hanging also. So it's sinking ship variation. Yeah, the bishop is not protected on this square, so I took it. And then let's attack the rook. And pin the rook. So the rook cannot move now. If it takes here, then I can attack the rook once more. So the rook cannot go here. So I'm 3 pieces up. This should be enough for winning this game, but José González is maybe a new player in chess, and so it's not quite sure how strong he is. 1500 is not saying anything, but when I look to his rating, he has made 8 games, so he's probably a beginner in chess, and that's okay. So you can review the game and look to the mistakes you made and then learn from it. And next time it will be better. And someday you will beat me. Marin Ten R, my next opponent. He is not connected, he has a very bad connection. Decent connection. Okay, he starts. So I have prepared now a new opening, which is this. Okay, so now we go back into a Aliechin defense or something like this. So it's normal for the knight to jump around 3 times. Let the opponent make some moves. And then think about that the pawns have moved so much and the piece development is not the best. So maybe in this case, okay, he's trying to check me here. Okay, this should be not too dangerous. So first I'm attacking the queen and the knight, and now I'm attacking this pawn here. Yeah, I know that you can make a check here and then take my queen, but I go away with my queen, so there is no way that I'm not taking this pawn. A pawn is a pawn. Oh, I missed this F4 move. This is not good, because he can win a piece. What he did, of course. So that's not good. Not a good start. So losing a piece is not so good. Okay, I got 2 points for it. But 2 points are only 2 points. So let's close up here this diagonal. It's very dangerous. And then I have to bring out my bishop, maybe here, then here. This e6 pawn is weak. So now he is trying to make something. But my queen can return home. So I cannot go here now. So let's bring the rook here for defending this pawn. Okay, and now I can go here. I can go here. If he goes here, it's not good. Okay, let's go the pawn here. Then I have a little bit against this threat here. So he is attacking this pawn here. Also, so let's go here, maybe. Or here, even better. Even better. Yeah. Let's go here. He is attacking my knight. And I don't like it. So I go here. So time wise 250, 240. That's okay. So I'm not behind time. I'm a lead in the time. Okay, he's giving up this bishop for my knight here. Do I really want to do it? Do I really want to give up my knight? No. Oh, why not give it up? And then I think I have enough pressure here, because he missed this rook move, and I won this game, luckily. So I'm in the lead. I'm in the lead of the tournament. Means, of course, that I now get only the strongest opponents. And here we are. This is strange. Is playing, of course, the berserk mode. Let's go back. Defend the knight. Now my threat is to take here and win the queen. Take his queen. So my bishops are quite strong, I think. Okay, let's go back. So, less and less pieces on the board means that he has a bigger difficulty to checkmate me. So let's make here some space for my king. So I think that my king position is better. Okay, he wants to go here, so I protect this pawn, so that I can move this one. Did I really made a mistake? No. Yes. I made a mistake. Made a big mistake. Yeah, let's give it up. A big, big mistake in the end game. Big, big. So that's good. Now I'm on the third spot. So. This is a little bit risky, I think. But okay. I'm castling here and then attack on the king side. So first of all, I bring my knight to a good position. So I'm preparing now this pawn move here, and he cannot take. And my king is quicker here on the action. And now I have a passed pawn, which is quite nice. Of course. Checkmate! Wow, this is a surprise. A checkmate by my opponent, which brings me back to the second spot with 6 points. 36 minutes to go. So this tournament is definitely better than the last two ones. The last two ones are, I better forget them. And we have cooled down the temperature in Germany a little bit now. So it's not anymore over 30 degrees in the evening. It's only 27 or something. Fkusna. Uljesim. Oh. Venezuela, so his connection. So he beat me last time extremely hard in this Dutch, and this time I think I have Oh no, not again. I think I have looked to the game and of course I made a big mistake. And that's the normal move in the Dutch. You exchange this knight here for the pressure here and then force this bishop back. Back. Way back. So now the king, the queen has to do something. She's not doing anything, so I will exchange here everything. I don't mind to exchange this stuff here. So let's look how he do it, how he does react now. And now he will lose. Because his rook is in a super bad spot. The rook is lost now. Okay, this pawn is lost also, but it's only a pawn. Who cares about pawns? This is a check. Okay, so I think I'm not too bad here, so I can give away my knight, but I don't want to give it away because this knight, okay, it can jump here. Can jump here. Okay, I'm attacking the spawn here. He tries to defend it. Thank you. So this pawn is attacked two times now. It's only defended once. So this looks not bad for me. This game looks really not bad for me. I can take here with the rook. So I'm 5 points ahead. So my threat is now rook here and then rook here, checkmate. And I don't know how he will stop it. And now he gives up because there is no real defense against this. It's too strong my attack. So this gives me 8 points. Very nice. This was a good game. I played it very well. With the Dutch Leningrad defense for black is really difficult, and stronger opponents always try to crush me. If they know it or not, they try to crush me because they think it's a bad opening. But it's not a bad opening. In the last title Thursday on Lead Chess, Magnus Carlsen played it 2 times with black, so it's not so bad of an opening. Oh, I take it. I don't know what to do, so I take it. Okay, this is dangerous. This is dangerous, so I will play maybe here. No, that's all dangerous. It's all very dangerous. I can play here and then castle. If he goes now with the rook, with the... go back? No. I go here. If he takes it, I take back with the knight. And if he doesn't take it, I go here. Should I be worried? No. I go just here. Okay, I can take this pawn here. But is this a good idea? No, it's not a good idea, because he will lose now a piece. He will not lose a piece. Sundram. I have to get rid of this knight here. And now I think I will. Win this pawn here. Yeah, I think I will win this pawn here now. Anyway, how he moves the knight, I can go here and say, okay, adios knight, go away. The knight has to go away, and then I can take the... In this case, it's even easier, because I can attack the pawn quicker than he can defend it. I go here and now check, then I go here. And now his pawns are a little bit weaker than mine. Yeah, this should be a draw. Back to the tournament. There's no way to make progress. Not for me. Carlsen maybe made some progress in this position, but for me it's completely a draw. So I have changed my white, my opening for white. Oh, what's this? This is a kind of gambit or something, which I of course don't know, but I know what to do here. So it's what to do here? Give a check. If in doubt, just give a check. Then double here the and exchange the bishop here. Rook of Gero is of course one of the dangerous players. Okay, let's go back. So, okay, this pawn is only protected one time and attacked two times. So, if he takes, take back. I'll take back with the rook. He definitely missed to take the pawn here. My queen is protected. My queen is protected, yes. Let's protect her one more time. Yeah, but now I can just go here. Now he's attacking this pawn again. Okay. I can go here. Go out of the pin and attack this pawn. No, that's not good. I'm uncomfortable with this position. Gives me a lot of trouble here. I cannot defend my knight two times, so I have to move it. I have to move my knight. Now my queen. I really don't like the position of my pieces here. All in white squares. And now the queen is coming. So let's go here, maybe. The pawn is only protected one time. Can I go here? Okay, let's go here. Maybe. Maybe I can advance the pawn here. Too late. So get rid of one pair of the rooks. And then this pawn is attacked. That's not good. It's all not good. So now I can attack something. That's good. I can attack this pawn here. But I have to be careful with my back rank. I cannot put the knight between the king, so either I go with the king here or I open a hole here, and then the knight is not longer protected. Yeah, I cannot take the queen. But I can take this knight, and then I can open a hole, and now the queen is under attack. And this knight is pinned since a long time now. Okay, I will win this pawn here. And I'm attacking this pawn also. Okay, this was a little bit stupid. This was stupid. The two pawns and a rook. This should be one for black. Okay, he's preparing this devil move here for sure to win the rook, but I saw it. I cannot really take this pawn. Because then he has this pawn moving and winning. So I need a trick, any kind of a trick. Okay. I tried my best, but of course with 2 points more it's completely lost. But I tried my best. So we have 9 minutes to go. Sundram again. So he plays the Dutch. Let's see what kind of Dutch he is playing. Looks like a classical Dutch. It's not good. I have to go away because I don't want to lose my queen. Okay, this was not the right decision in this moment, but really I don't want to lose the queen. But I lose a piece. I lost a piece. Six minutes to play in the tournament. I think I take this pawn here. Why not? Why not? I need any kind of trick. Okay, here it is. Attacking the rook. And the rook is pinned. And he attacks my queen. Cool. So still cannot take, but he can take here. Okay, give it up. Come on, give it up. Back to the tournament. 10 points, rank 7. Okay, 1 or 2 points more would be nice, so that I get 1 point in the tournament. But it's only 4 minutes. I will not play against him. Oh, what is happening here? Louis again, okay, I will be second this time. So 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go. Oh, my pawn, I should defend it. Okay, check. Let's give a check. We saw it. Okay. So I'm attacking the knight or the pawn, so I take the pawn. You can take here. Oh. Oh, oh. It's the same. The same fork on the other side. So 30 seconds in the tournament. No, I cannot take the pawn. So the tournament is over. That's checkmate. You can take here. Yeah, he did it. But now this pawn is running too fast. Okay, back to the tournament. Okay, I got the screenshot. So I thank everybody for taking part. 22 players now in the tournament finally. So let's see to the end of the table. So a lot of games but no points, so a little bit disappointing for them maybe, but that's absolutely no problem. Learn from your mistakes and play a little better next time, and then you get a few points. So, okay, I see a lot of players here. So, thank you everybody and see you next time. Have a nice evening. Bye bye.